Beirut keeps getting all the heat. The IAF bombarded last night the southern quarter of the city, known as the Shiite center that identifies with the Hezbollah. Same thing happened today in Tyre, the place from which rockets are fired towards Israel's coastal cities. Now, Lebanon is trying to assess how big is the damage the draft introduced by France and the US has caused. One of the hardest sections for them to swallow is the Israeli army staying on Lebanese soil until the agreement is complete. Even Lebanese Prime Minister Senyora understands he has to find common ground between his seven-point plan and the future UN resolution.
الكامل للقوات الإسرائيلية من الأقسام التي احتلتها على الحدود اللبنانية الإسرائيلية على الخط الأزرق ويجب أن ينص أيضا على معالجة المشكلة الأساس وهي مشكلة الاحتلال لمنطقة مزارع شبعة.
Everyone on the streets of Beirut will tell you the proposal doesn't benefit Lebanon.
يا بنوت سبعة يا ما في حل.
And while Israel was bombing Beirut, Walid Mualim, the Syrian foreign minister, arrived in the city. Just earlier this year, the Syrians were expelled from Lebanon, and now they come to state the real problem with the U.S.'s draft resolution.
أن من يعتقد أن القضاء على حزب الله بقواته العسكرية الجرارة وبالجسر الجوي الأمريكي لإسرائيل أقول لإسرائيل والولايات المتحدة أنهم واهمون.
Lebanon keeps shouting the proposal isn't fair. Syrian President Assad, sitting in Damascus, knows everyone awaits his response and makes it clear that the current proposal doesn't suffice him.